Something I just got away from as I got older, and it was something that became no longer important to me. But it took a back burner position, and it was not anything that was present in my life for a very long time. But as I got older, things progressively got worse. I started working after I got out of college. I was working these 100-hour weeks and traveling the country, so cocaine was my best friend. It allowed me to keep working those jobs, keep busy and stay on task for these crazy weeks, these long days. And just my addiction just spiraled out of control. And I went to a second rehab and stayed sober for almost a year. Things went pretty well for a while, and it just kind of just crept back in. Things picked up where they left off. I came back home after kind of a cry to help to my family. And they, my mom found out about life challenge from a pastor, from a friend of ours that goes to Northridge. And they, I was like, I do not want to go to Bible camp. It was something that I had not relied on for a long time. It was not important to me anymore in my life, so I just didn't. This wasn't for me. And the more I thought about it, you know, I tried AA and NA and other things like that. It's like, maybe I do need Jesus. You know, that's one thing I haven't tried. Maybe that is the answer. And so, reluctantly, I got in the car and came up here, and I'm still putting up a fight. I try not to, but, you know, every day my walls break down a little more, and it's, I'm kind of earning my faith back day by day, and it's kind of cool. I don't see the change in myself, the people around me do, and that's important to me because it's really, I mean, I'm here to help other people, and it's important to me that my family and the relationships are restored, that I'm somewhat broken in the path, and I caused a little bit of chaos too. So everything's great, and thank you guys for doing this for us. We appreciate you.
Hey guys, so my name is Sean. Just want to thank all you guys for everything you do for us. You know, your pastors come out and see us a couple times a month, give us a good word, buy us lunch, play music with us. It's awesome. We love you guys. So my story, just give you the short version. I was an alcoholic, am an alcoholic, and I was a functioning alcoholic for many years, worked in bars, bartending, you know, musician, playing music, going to school, doing the whole thing throughout my 20s. And toward the end of my 20s, it just kind of all came crashing down for me. I fell into a really deep depression, diagnosed, and I didn't really know how to cope with it, so I just used alcohol to cope with it, which is a depressant, so didn't really work out too well for me. This year, I ended up moving down to Nashville, trying to kind of run away from my problems, thinking that I could get a fresh start, that if I go down there, I'll get wrapped up in the music. I was going back to school. Just thought it would be exactly what I needed. It lasted 2 months. 2 months. I was in and out of the hospital. My blood alcohol content at one point was a 0.466, which is should be dead. Doctors told me that, too. I was in the mental hospital after a couple suicide attempts. It was really bad. It didn't work out well for me down in Nashville. But what happened was I realized that I cannot do this on my own. There's nowhere I can run. There's nowhere I can go. These problems will follow me. And the cool thing about it was that while I was there, God was chasing me the whole time.
Amen.
And I ended up, my parents came and got me from Nashville and brought me back up to here, and I ended up in Life Challenge. And it was the best thing I could have made. I put off the decision for a few years. I tried rehab. I tried, you know, AA meetings, NA meetings, which have their place, but I was doing it without God. I was doing it by my own will, which is not powerful enough. And so when I came to Life Challenge, I just prayed to God. I said, God, I'm just going to be here. I'm going to knock on that door until you answer me, because I've got walls, I've got a hard heart, and I don't know what to do. I was lost. I was broken. And slowly but surely, God's been working in me. He's been breaking down those walls. I'm playing worship music for the first time in my life. And I'm clear-headed, and I'm learning a ton about the Word, and I'm growing closer to God every single day. And it's not easy. It's tough. It's a big transition living sober now, dealing with depression sober. But the cool thing is, at the end of the night, I know that I can always just close my eyes and talk to God and talk to Jesus and say, thank you for keeping me alive. I'm not dead. It's awesome. And now, I just want to live for God and do what His will is for my life, whatever that may be. So I'm taking this time to figure that out, and I'm just really glad to be at Life Challenge. Thank you.